In this video, I'm going to show you how to build 13 more powerful shortcuts using ChatGPT 4.0. From having it summarize any document, whether it's a PDF, Word document, or otherwise, automate shortcuts to summarize emails as they come in, no action even needed on your part. Automate text messages with ChatGPT, get descriptions of images, get highlights from the books you're reading, and a ton more. You guys really blew up that last ChatGPT video. Thank you for doing that. I'll link the first video down in the description. So if you're watching this one first, definitely check out that one because a lot of people found really useful shortcuts over there. All right, this first shortcut, I'm gonna call summarize document, but it's gonna do way more than just documents. Links to all of these shortcuts will be in the description as well, so you could just download and use them right away. But this one is gonna be using the share sheet on your iPhone, and it's gonna ask for any kind of file. I have an if statement here, whether or not it's a PDF or just a regular document. And one of the shortcuts actions you can use is get text from PDF or get text just from any document. After that, I have a ChatGPT prompt here that says the following is text from a document. Give me a 200 word or less summary of its contents. It sends that request to ChatGPT 4.0 and then will show me that summary. Now you can do something like copy it to a clipboard or add it to a note, but because it's in the share sheet, this becomes really powerful. You can use it on email attachments or files you have on your Mac or on your iPhone. I'm gonna go to one of the files that I have in my Files app. This is actually a PDF, and I can just hit the share button, and then if I scroll down, I'll see my summarized document shortcut right here. When I tap that, it's pulling the text from the PDF document, sending it to ChatGPT to summarize, and you can see how quickly it provides a summary for that PDF document right here on my iPhone. Now for number two, it's actually the same shortcut, but I've enabled it to accept more than just files. It can also accept plain text or rich text, so you can use it anywhere you can select text on your phone, iPad, or on your Mac. For instance, maybe I got a long email from someone and I just want to know the bullet points. Well, I can just select all the text in the email. I'll just go all the way down. It's all selected. And then once that text is selected, I can go in this little contextual menu and hit the share option. And from here, I'll see that same summarized document shortcut. If I do that, it's gonna send the plain text that I've selected here straight to ChatGPT to summarize it for me. And now I have a shorter summary of the email, and you can adjust that prompt if you want even less text, 120 characters or less, or to put it in bullet points. So now you can summarize those long emails in just a few seconds. But here's the wild part. You can actually automate this to summarize emails as they come in before you even look at them. Here in the Automations tab, I'm gonna hit the plus button, and if I scroll down, you can see one of the triggers is actually email. When I select that, I can choose who the sender is. So maybe you have a boss or someone that you just wanna summarize their emails as soon as they come in. You can type the sender's email address here. You can leave subject contains blank and it'll just summarize every email from that sender, or you can specify the subject. Maybe you get an email every week at your job that says agenda for the week. We'll put part of that subject here and it'll summarize those emails. You can choose what account this automation is gonna watch and who the email is to. I choose to run immediately. So I'm gonna type here that any email from this address, podcast@primarytech.fm, which is my tech podcast, you should totally listen, links are in the description. And when it gets sent to this email account that I have set up on my phone, run immediately. I'll tap next, I'm gonna choose new blank automation, and now I'm gonna search for the run shortcut action. And from here, I can choose that summarized document shortcut. That's all I have to do. I hit done, and now let's see what happens when I get an email. So I just sent this email to myself. I'm gonna go back to my iPhone home screen. You can see that email just came in, and now that shortcut is running in the background. I'm just gonna let it do its thing. That means I'm gonna get a summary in just a few seconds. And there we go, it summarized that email automatically as soon as it hit my inbox. If you want, you can also add this to a note, like I said before, or somewhere else where you'll keep the summaries of those emails. Number three, this same shortcut can work on text. Let's say you have a friend or someone who just sends really, really long texts. I've slightly adjusted the shortcut to summarize text messages. From here, I just have the prompt at the top and then clipboard as an action here in the text block. It asks ChatGPT, and then I did a shorter summary of 100 words. Now, when it comes to text messages, there's no share option. I can tap and hold on even a really long message, but even the more option doesn't allow me to actually access the share sheet. So instead, what I'm gonna do is tap and hold on it, tap copy, and now you can put this to the action button or somewhere else that's easily accessible, but I'll go over to my summarized text shortcut, gets that text from the clipboard, then it's gonna show me a 100 word summary right here on my phone. And now you have summaries of text messages. All right, number four, in a previous shortcuts video, I had made this shortcut, which actually has some random text messages that will automatically send to someone else at a specific time in the morning. But we can do even better now with ChatGPT. Here in the text prompt, I'm gonna write something like, every morning I'm going to text my wife, Whitney, a nice good morning text. Start with a greeting, saying something like, I hope you enjoy your day, and that I'll see you after work. Make the text short, fun, and use at least one emoji. So that's going to be the prompt for GPT. I'm going to add an action after that, which is ask GPT. I'm going to select the text variable, the prompt that I just wrote above. Let's go with GPT-4.0. I'm going to add a quick look action just to see what it does with that. GPT is thinking about it. Hopefully it comes up with something good. And there's the text. It's not bad. We'll see how it does long term. But that's the text I can now send to my significant other. So I'm going to take away that quick look action, and now I'm going to choose send message. I'm going to have it just send it to me for right now. I'm going to click play. Let's see what it does. I'm going to have to change that prompt around to vary this a little bit more. And you can add more to that prompt, like choose from one of these random texts or reword one of these prompts. But if I want this to send automatically, I can expand that window, uncheck the show and run, and now this is ready to automate. Now I can go to the automate tab here in shortcuts, hit the plus button, choose time of day. Maybe we'll do every day at 7:50 in the morning. We'll do daily, run immediately. Then we can do new blank automation, choose the run shortcut action, and we'll do the random morning text GPT. Hit done, and now that text will send every morning at the same time, hopefully a little less robotic and a little more random. All right, this next email is the team email GPT. That's what I'm calling it. And what this shortcut does is gonna have me dictate text, and then I have a prompt here. Basically, I'm gonna tell ChatGPT some important points for my team and that we're having a meeting at 10 a.m. where we'll go over it more in detail. It's going to take that raw information that I give it as I dictate, send it to ChatGPT to create an email from that, and then I can automatically populate an email. And for the subject, I manually put weekly agenda and then use the current date, no time. This way that email is up to date. So I'm going to play this shortcut and add some important information. We have some big projects this week, like the client for the travel company. And so we're going to talk about their website. Then we're going to do a creative brief for a new brand that we're going to be onboarding in the fitness category. And then we need to talk about some of the hardware upgrades across the team, who might need a new computer. And then finally, we'll talk about the retreat that's coming up next week. So I just kind of dictated my raw thoughts there. It's actually going to send that to ChatGPT to formulate it into an email. And then it's going to show me the email compose sheet ready to send. You can see the subject was already populated with what I placed and today's date. There's a greeting to the team, and it has the agenda right here numbered. Looking forward to seeing them at the meeting, 10 a.m., and it's ready to send. You can also expedite this process even more if you want to put the recipients here. You can tap here and add the specific recipients of your team, and even have this email send automatically by expanding this menu. Uncheck the compose sheet. You can choose what email address you want this email to send from, and this will just run automatically after you dictate that text. And number six, I actually had someone who wanted GPT to hopefully identify things in an image. Now, unfortunately, you can't pass an image to GPT through shortcuts. So what I've done here is created an automation that we'll use in the share sheet for photos. And I've used two actions here. One is from Toolbox Pro, which can actually recognize objects in a photo. So it'll try its best to see what's in the photo. And there's a built-in action in shortcuts that will extract text from an image. So I have that extracting from the shortcut input. Then I have a prompt here for ChatGPT saying, I'm trying to describe what's in this image. There's also a percentage accuracy that Toolbox Pro provides. So include that, put it all together in a message, and it's gonna show it in a quick look. You can also change this to the speak text action. This way it will read it out to you. Now this might work on images you come across in the web as well, but I've saved this image to my photo library, which is a restaurant menu. I'll hit the share button, scroll down, and I'll tap my describe image GPT. When I tap that, it's gonna try and use OCR to pull the text, get a description of the images using that Toolbox Pro action, and then show it to me right here in Quick Look. Again, add a speak text at the end if you want it to audibly tell you what it sees. And it's telling you this is a menu with 96% accuracy, actually has the main course choices with the prices next to it. And I think it did a pretty good job of pulling all that text out of it. Now, depending on what's in the picture, you're gonna get varied results. Like here's my iPad Pro with Magic Keyboard. Let's see what it does if I run my describe image GPT. Now this says it might be a notebook computer with 56% accuracy. I'm sorry if that upsets you, calling an iPad a computer, but don't worry, we'll get through this together. Your mileage may vary with this shortcut, but you can download it in the video description and try it out yourself. Speaking of OCR from images, I actually built this shortcut because I like reading physical books, but then I can't save my highlights and I don't like writing in my books. So sometimes what I'll do is just take a picture of the page where I found something interesting or inspirational and save that for later. But a lot of times they sit in my camera roll and I'm not sure what to do with them. So I created this GPT, which will take an image from the share sheet, use that extract text from input, so from the photo, and I told ChatGPT this is part of a book, summarize it for me with relevant points, and then show it in Quick Look. Of course, you can change this to add it to a note. Maybe you have a note for the book with all the interesting quotes. Well, you can add that at the end of the shortcut. So now when I have my picture of a book, I'll hit that share button, go down to my book photo GPT, tap that. It's going to use OCR to recognize the text from that page, and it gave me a summary with some headings and bullet points that then I can add to a note. This is a little lengthy, so you can change the prompt to say only give me 200 characters or give it to me strictly in bullet points, but a nice way to actually save text from that book, and I can just copy and paste, share this, or again, automatically add it to a note. For shortcuts 8 and 9, spell checking with ChatGPT and rewriting in a different tone of voice, I'm actually going to point you to Matthew Casinelli's website. He has a bunch of great shortcuts here like spell check and rewrite with ChatGPT. You can find a link to his website down in the description and download those shortcuts directly from his website. Matthew is an incredible shortcuts guru, and a lot of what I know about shortcuts I learned from Matthew Casinelli. So check him out down in the description. All right, for number 10, we're going to create a morning news GPT. So let's create a new shortcut using the plus button here, and we're going to pull news sources from several RSS feeds. I'm going to search for the RSS action and then get items from RSS feed. I'm going to choose three items, and that will be the three most recent items. We'll choose Apple's RSS feed first, but let's duplicate this and add a couple other news sources. So I've added two other RSS feeds, Daring Fireballs and 9 to 5 Max. So these three actions are going to get the three most recent items from these feeds. Now under each feed, I'm going to add a repeat with each action. That means for each of these three items, it's going to perform the following actions. I use the get details from article action to get the body of that repeat item, so the text of that. I did have to add an action after each repeat with item, which is the get URLs from repeat item. The shortcut you download in the video description will have it all, and it's working properly, so you can check it out down there. Then I'm going to add a text block underneath that, and use a prompt that summarizes the content. Then I'm going to choose that prompt for ChatGPT. Let's select ChatGPT 4.0, and that's going to give me that summary. So those three summaries that ChatGPT is going to generate, it's actually going to combine those results in a single block of text using this action. And then I'm going to choose a set variable. I know I might not need to do this, it just makes it easier to work with later. I'll make that the Apple variable. Now I'm going to quickly add these same actions, the repeat with each, get body, summarize it, and then ChatGPT, and combine for the other news sources. All right, so here I've built it all out. I'm repeating with every RSS item from the three sources, setting the variable at the end. And then after all three repeat with RSS actions, I'm combining all the results with this prompt, saying summarize the news for me, remove duplicate information, and I put the three variables there, Apple, Gruber, 9 to 5, and then show that text in the Quick Look. Let's run this shortcut. The first time you run it, it's gonna ask you to allow from different URLs. So while this is running, I will say I had to change the GPT model to 3.5. 4.0 was failing pretty regularly, sometimes 4 was as well. So if you want the most reliable summaries and for this shortcut to run without any issues, I would try ChatGPT 3.5. And that's how I'll have this set in the downloaded link in the video description. But now it summarized all those articles from three different RSS feeds, put it all together, and now here's my news summary across all those different RSS feeds. You can add even more RSS feeds or get more articles, and then add a speak text if you want the shortcut to just speak the news for you. So that's the Apple News GPT. Number 11, I had created a morning routine in a previous shortcut video. I'll link that playlist down below. Just, you know, binge them all. And so here's the morning routine, which gets your calendar events, current weather, driving time to a work location. And now I've added another action, which is run that Apple News GPT, and I've added it to our summary text here. So here's the news, added the shortcut result as a variable, and now if you run this morning GPT, it'll give you this full report plus that summary of the news that we just created in the previous shortcut. Nice little start to the day you can listen to while you're brushing your teeth. Number 12, I'm actually going to go over to the Mac GPT app, and this is something I do with every one of my videos. ChatGPT is great at title, description, and tag ideas for videos on my channel and for Riverside. So I have here a transcript of a video that I recently created. And so what I have here is actually a text expander prompt. I call it semicolon VGPT. This is the prompt that I start with and basically ask ChatGPT to give me a title, description, and tags I can copy and paste into YouTube. And then ChatGPT pretty quickly gives me a title ideas, description, and these tags, which are comma separated, so I can just copy and paste in that tag box for my videos. And of course, I can go back and ask it for more title ideas and maybe massage the description a little bit. But if you make YouTube videos, podcasts, or something you need just titles and descriptions for really quickly, taking the transcript of your content, putting it through ChatGPT with a little prompt makes it super easy. All right, and number 13, I actually need your help. So I call this my Summarize Podcast GPT. I've had a lot of people ask me, can you just make a shortcut that summarizes podcasts? So I'm really close to it. There's a couple caveats. So one is this shortcut starts with pulling via RSS. So I have this pulling the latest episode of Primary Technology. And the only way this is going to work is if the podcast actually has a transcript via that RSS feed and it's easily available in a predictable format. So I host Primary Technology with Transistor.fm. They're awesome, I'll just be honest. And their format is pretty simple. It's the website URL, the number of the episode, and then if you want to go directly to the transcript, you just do /transcript. So I can pull the most recent episode this way via the RSS feed. Now, after that, I can get the text of that URL, but the problem I'm having with is ChatGPT, it's going to max out at 4,000-ish characters, and it's just going to fail. If you give it an entire transcript for a podcast, it won't do it. So I'm trying to split the text by a custom regex. I believe these are regex or real express. I'm not really sure what it's called. But this right here is what I need help with. How can I split the text from this transcript in 4,000 character chunks? Once this is possible, then you can do a repeat with each, and I send each of those 4,000 character chunks of the podcast transcript through ChatGPT. It's going to be summarizing those portions, and then I combine those results with new lines in a master summary of the entire show, ask ChatGPT for that, and then it creates a new note in Bear for me, or you could have Quick Look, add it to Apple Notes, with that full podcast summary. I've gotten this to work-ish as long as I use less than 4,000 characters, but of course you want this to do with a full transcript. Now again, this is only going to work with shows that have a predictable URL scheme and a dedicated URL for the transcript, either in their RSS feed or maybe their website, but this is what I need help with right here. What is the expression that consistently works in shortcuts where I can split text by 4,000 character chunks? So if you know how that works, leave a comment below this video. I'd love to feature that in my next shortcuts video, which have a bunch of other requests that I've been filling up, and so I'm going to do one of those soon. So subscribe to the channel for more shortcuts videos, and remember, I have an entire playlist, both of shortcuts and specific shortcut request videos. I'll put one of those recent videos right up here. And did I mention subscribe to the channel before you go? Do that. Hit the like button, and if you want even more automations, maybe like for your smart home, I have a bunch of smart home videos as well. I put my latest one talking about sensors and HomeKit automations right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.